Hi, this is Patrick Egan, publisher of the Green Building Journal. You're watching part 4 of a 5-part video series in which we'll walk through a standard energy audit of a 4-bedroom, 2,200 square foot Craftsman remodel. In this segment, we'll focus on lighting efficiency. In other parts of this series, we'll cover the initial interview, checking for HVAC leaks using a duct blaster, general HVAC efficiency, and the smoke test using a blower door to check for structure air tightness.
The lighting that we've got in the house and what kind of savings can we see by using a different type of lighting, and how much energy is it using, even what type of heat is it putting out, that's going to decrease our cooling as well too.
Absolutely.
All right.
Well, two important points to begin. Mm-hmm. One, you guys have done a great job so far, already having a mostly CFL system. Mm-hmm. But just because you've done well doesn't mean there's not room for improvement,
sure.
Especially with LED technology that's really starting to hit the market and the bulbs' prices are going down. So now might be the time to invest if you want to be, a leader. Mm-hmm. And soon enough, it's going to be cost effective to get these things with paybacks under 2 years.
Sure.
So that's an exciting change in the space. And LED, without a doubt, is the future of lighting.
Okay, cool.
The other part is lighting is really what creates the magic of an interior space.
Gotcha.
And you want to be very careful not to make a retrofit for energy savings that ends up making you unhappy where you live.
Okay.
So I brought a few LED bulbs today to show. I've bought these all recently at Ace, mm-hmm. other than this one, which was given to me at a trade show.
Okay.
This is a 6-watt bulb. It's designed to replace a 60-watt halogen, like would be in there. So
gotcha.
90% energy savings.
Mm-hmm.
It has a very nice color temperature, a nice warm light.
Mm-hmm.
This one is designed for vanities.
Okay.
It creates a spherical light, and it's designed to have a good color rendering index, so what you look like in the light is what you look like in reality.
Gotcha.
And then this one is designed to replace any sort of spotlight,
mm-hmm.
or it's really good for exterior lights as well. This one's 10 watts, 8 watts, and then 6 watts again.
Okay, great. And so in here right now, let's see, we've got, let me turn this on. These are 60-watt halogen or halogen or something like that.
And this one's not turning on. Let's turn it off for 1 second.
It's probably dead now.
Yeah.
So?
Well, we'll
maybe we should replace that one.
Maybe we should replace it. How perfect is that, right?
Alrighty, cool.
Alright. And even though it kind of feels like nails on chalkboard when you do this, it's one of my favorite feelings. Alright.
All right,
let's hope that the fixture's working. And there we go.
Alright, great.
Beautiful. And if I remember correctly, you told me that that's an older halogen model. That's
yes.
A newer one.
Correct.
And now this is the LED.
Correct.
And the LED matches the newer halogen's color.
Mm-hmm.
And most people buy halogens because of the color.
Sure, definitely.
And it also is saving about 90% of the energy and putting out a lot less heat.
Hmm.
So in Santa Barbara, that's generally a good idea.
Heat's a good thing. Well, I know you brought your infrared camera. Let's see
that's right.
What kind of heat we are getting out of the thing.
All right, so if we aim this there, that's pretty amazing. You can barely tell that the LED is on. The other halogen is still warming up,
mm-hmm.
but the one that's been on for a while is well over 90 degrees. And earlier today when we measured it, it was hitting about 114 after being on for a while.
Oh, that's interesting.
And now the LED, again, it barely looks like it's on, and it's the same temperature as the ambient temperature in the room.
That's amazing.
And again, putting out great quality of light.
And you say that one's 6 watts.
6 watts.
Versus the 60-watt halogen.
Versus 60 watts.
And it's not heating up my room.
Not heating up your room.
I think we'll be replacing all three of those lights today.
Let's hope so.
Alrighty.
And then moving on to the kitchen space.
Mm-hmm.
What's important to note is that it's important to notice 1 o'clock, apparently. What's important to note is that if a light is not on too often,
mm-hmm.
there's usually no point in replacing it unless the idea is that you never want to deal with maintenance on that again.
Right.
But lights that are on more than, say, 6 hours a day, it's always worth looking into doing a retrofit on the
lighting. Sounds good. Right.
Or we prefer to use the term upgrade now.
Gotcha. Right.
And you had mentioned that these two guys hanging in the middle, those mm-hmm. two fixtures, were on all the time. So those would be a good option to look into from here.
Right, and those are 60 watt or 75
watt
incandescents. They're on a dimmer, and that was my big concern when we originally did the remodel, that we couldn't go with a CFL in that spot because we couldn't dim the CFLs.
That's true. They do have dimmable CFLs now, but again, they're pretty expensive, and if you're going to spend the money, as far as durability and light quality goes, I'd recommend looking to an LED solution for those as well.
Great. Cool.
To view the rest of the videos in this series, just visit greenbuildingpro.com.